6th of June 1944. In the largest battle armada in history, more than 130,000 Allied troops landed in Normandy. Key to the invasion was air power. Allied air forces flew over 14,000 sorties in support of the landings, and over 5,000 aircraft were under RAF control. Our men and women in Bomber Command flew 1,300 sorties in support of the invasion. Their role, to bomb ports, roads and railways in northern France and German military installations. Thousands of British soldiers were flown to the battlefield by the RAF's Transport Command. By the end of the 6th of June, the RAF had delivered 4,310 paratroopers to Normandy and 310 gliders full of soldiers and supplies. On the ground, our boys had help from the RAF's Tactical Air Force, who flew 4,386 sorties in just 48 hours. Flying low over Normandy, their job was to observe enemy forces, spot land targets for our battleships, and close air support for our troops. Fighter Command didn't miss out either. They flew 1,246 sorties on D-Day. Their support was vital in defending the invasion force by air, escorting our bombers, and keeping the Luftwaffe at bay. Last but not least was Coastal Command, who flew 2,197 sorties to support the invasion. They protected the Allied Armada from the German Navy and cut the enemy's coastal supply lines. Victory didn't come without sacrifice. 113 Allied aircraft were lost supporting the invasion that led to the liberation of Western Europe.